Pakistan's southern Sindh province, hit by devastating monsoon rains this year, has once again inundated millions of homes and displaced millions of people, many of whom have previously had little or no access to any form of health or medical assistance. The most vulnerable among the displaced victims are children, pregnant women, young mothers, and newborn babies. Rani is a 25-year-old mother of three who became widowed a month ago when her husband, who has been suffering with tuberculosis, died during the floods.
We were fleeing our village when he fell down and died. We had to bury him along the way.
10 days after the death of her husband, Rani gave birth to a premature baby boy at the school where she and her family are now taking shelter. Her baby, Omji, has been sick ever since his birth.
He has been suffering from severe diarrhea and is not taking much milk. I don't know why. We heard there was a medical team coming, so we went to seek help.
UNICEF, together with its implementing partners, are sending out mobile medical teams with women health officers that visit every village, providing medical assistance, immunization, vaccinations, and bed nets to women and children, besides pre- and postnatal care to mothers and their newborn babies.
When Rani came to me, her child was clinically premature and severely dehydrated. Rani is not producing enough breast milk, so the baby is not getting the required nutrition. There's hardly any awareness about hygiene either. Also, she is under considerable psychological trauma due to her husband's death, who died during the floods.
Our services include antenatal checkup, postnatal care and deliveries. We have set up referral centers where family planning services, tetanus vaccinations and immunization services are being provided. We are also conducting health education sessions where awareness is being given to communities on health and hygiene, because these displaced communities have no access to safe drinking water. Our main focus is on mothers and children. We are conducting these interventions in 7 districts together with our UN partners.
Though basic health interventions have begun, there is an urgent need to upscale, as many flood victims are suffering from chronic diarrhea, dysentery and skin conditions. Most of the children are malnourished. Though emergency health interventions have been initiated in IDP camps across the flood-affected areas of Tanduwalayar, Mirpur Khas, Badin and Sangar, much still needs to be done to equip and upscale the relief being provided to prevent the outbreak of life-threatening diseases or epidemics among the affected communities.